Hey, I'm Michael Bublé, and I wake up with the day. I guess it's half
time and the other half. I got some boobs on a Thursday morning. Good morning to you on this 4th of October. It is great to have your company.
And an officer in the US has rescued a scared chook from a burning shed.
I got one. I got your chicken.
The officer's colleagues have put him up for a special hero award.
What?
Almost a barbecue chook.
Oh, yeah.
Can we not overthink it?
Let's not overthink it.
I love chicken.
Good on the hero cop.
I had chicken last night.
I know someone who... Did you?
Barbecue chicken, yeah.
We know someone who loves a chook. Stevie Jacobs. Good morning.
The Birdman.
Oh, what a lovely throw. Thanks, G. Yeah. Never mess with a black chook. I never got an award for messing with a black chook.
No.
You should have. You
should. Yeah, I definitely should have.
Oh, one at a time, one at a time, one at a time. Go on, get it in there. Go on. Bite it. Bite it. Go on. All right. There you go. All right, I'm going to have a go.
Oh, my God.
Oh. All right. Grimace.
It's just got to sit in there.
Hey.
Here he goes, the big Gilbert.
It's giving, doesn't it?
It does.
Oh. Where did it go? Oh, it just
consumed the whole lot.
It's gone.
Skin and all.
Everywhere.
Yeah. Okay, it's hard for mums too, so, you know, to get sometimes the care and the way we understand the balance.
Been there,
that's,
done that.
That's only one decision. Do you think I need to have my eyebrows done? Because you know a lot of guys do it, but it's a big decision for a bloke to go to hand over and go, you know what, I'm going to start the manscaping.
Well, I've never looked that closely, but now that you bring it up, yes, I think there are a few stray eyebrows there that could be waxed, and in fact, I might be your woman for the job.
Georgie's Monday morning on today.
Georgie waxes Carl. Oh, you sickos.
God.
That's disgusting.
I just thought that through.
If you want to see that on Monday morning, Georgie wax Carl, send us an email or send us some social media.
Oh, wax, as in wax.
And not axe.
No, wax.
Apparently, go on, high five that.
Apparently you've already been axed.
Yeah. Gone. Gone. A couple of weeks ago. Don't mention the war.
Monday morning, on today.
Carl axed and waxed. I'm coming for that.
Police in the United States had an unusual call out when a rogue goat was seen grazing in a Texas car park. Officers chased down the wandering animal, laughing as they radioed their colleagues to confirm they had it in custody.
You know what song we're singing in the background? Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do?
Oh, yeah, you nailed that one. Well done.
Always thinking.
Wish I'd thought of that.
I mean, it could be anything that I think of. It just sort of pops in, pops out.
Yeah.
It's funny, isn't it? That's right.
It's a curious thing, your head, isn't it? In some ways, I'd like to get inside it, but another way, definitely not.
Oh, no.
It's you might get lost.
From the outside, yeah.
15 degrees, so count your blessings, people.
Looks like
nothing will rain
dog.
On that parade, Natalia.
That's a sausage dog on her
it's
head.
Not a sausage dog. That's uncharitable, Carl.
Is it?
Beautiful.
I'm not saying a sausage dog on your head is a bad thing. I'm just saying.
Well, it's beautiful. They all look exquisite.
Don't they? I've got my tip. Do you want my tip?
Yeah, what is your tip?
Okay, everyone get your pen and papers out.
Well, you tore up my bit of paper. But
Just write it on my hand.
Yeah.
So my tip is
you
can tan.
Oh.
Oh, no, that's...
Where does that come from?
It comes from the Latin derivative, you can tan.
As in, I can tan.
No, you can tan.
You can tan.
I did tan. You can...
As if it's not going to win now.
Oh.
I've got a blister at
Endless.
The moment. I don't mind telling everyone at home. This is an extremely painful blister just in between my... And the, you know?
Oh.
I don't know if I can survive.
How are you dealing with that?
Well, not very well. I went for a big paddle, an ocean paddle, to raise money for the helicopter there in Sunshine Coast on the weekend, and I've got a blister.
You've got scars to show.
Yeah, and it's very painful.
I don't know what we're going to do about that.
Thank God you confirmed it was the paddling. Thank God you confirmed it was the paddling, Carl.
So you had... Because you had your man flu on Friday.
A man flu Friday
blister. This week.
Looks like you've got a cut. How are you alive this morning?
Well, that's a paper cut. Stop it.
We're falling apart.
I reckon we could contribute quite a bit of the Australian
collection from our own little cupboard out the back here, Channel 9. There's all sorts of history in this place.
Yeah.
There's all sorts of props.
Yeah, exactly. Lots of history in that joint.
Gee, that's an extensive collection.
Mm. Nerds Festival.
Whatever happened to the Humphrey outfit? Whatever happened to Humphrey B. Bear?
I don't know. His outfit could well be in the building right now.
He's not in the clink, is he?
No, he's all right.
Let's hope not.
No?
No, he's good.
Is it Fat Cat who's in the clink?
Well, I'm not sure.
One of them is.
I'm not going to cast aspersions
Humphrey,
about him.
Humphrey, he was a funny old fellow.
Mm. Exactly.
Yeah. And what a funny old fellow was he?
He was a funny old fellow. Tonight on A Current Affair.
No, you mustn't speak ill of Humphrey.
He's a fat cat.
He did forget his trousers though, didn't he?
He did.
He does get in all manner of strife.
Didn't have much to say sometimes as well. No comment.
Charlie, good morning. It sounds too good to be true. Is it worth all the hype?
I thought it was probably overhyped myself, guys, but that was because I think a lot of Australians haven't heard of the company that's making this handset, Huawei. Most Australians don't even know how to pronounce it. Yeah, you got it right. Huawei or whatever, but it's Huawei. I think there's some other cool stuff as well, like you take the earbud that they sell with it, put it in your ear, it will measure the jawbone vibrations of your face and unlock the phone using your voice. I haven't seen that before. That's pretty cool. So some new innovations and some improvements on other things out there that you probably haven't seen before.
What else can it do for my jawline?
Yeah, why?
Tighten it up a little, possibly?
Oh, you don't need tightening.
Oh, well, may as well ask.
That's yours. Tight, Georgie.
Yes, Carl. Let's talk about the wireless battery. How does that wireless battery work?
All right, so what it does is it's called reverse wireless charging, and you take the phone and you take any other phone that allows wireless charging and you put them together, and the Mate 20 Pro will then charge that other phone. So you're at a party or you're out on a shoot or whatever and your iPhone's about to run out of batteries. Well, someone's got a Mate 20 Pro there, you can charge directly off their phone.
Wow.
It's a very cool feature.
So you're at a party, you're charging your phone, your jaw's going nuts.
And you say, how about I charge you up?
I mean, this is the world's smartest phone.
I'm going to get it this time. OK, move that claw around and that way, and I'm going to give myself a bit of an advantage by shaking in the machine. Ah!
Simon,
our dodgy audio guy from Europe, from Sylvia's trip. And Sylves, I'm going to get him back for you because he's in there and I have the controls.
Him. Go on. Do it. Do it. Do it.
There's no way it's going to stick to that melon.
Oh! Oh, no! The crumb was too slippery.
G'day, guys. How are you?
This year, we're going rig to rig with the Poms. They got more cracks than a job site full of plumbers.
Carlos is excited. Settle down, big fella. Settle down.
Rev up your engines. I'm talking about me. Okay, here we go.
We're going ready.
Go, right.
I mean, this is
so what are we doing? Yeah, just get amongst it now.
What are we doing? Oh, yeah. You guys all got... Oh, yeah.
Burner.
Oh, well done. So mobile for a big man.
That's
well
not
done,
easy.
Boys. Big round of applause.
All right.
The competition.
All right, ready?
And good morning, Victoria Beckham, watching on. Oh, this is... Oh, wow. Yeah. I've never seen anything like it. Round of applause.
Now, they don't come cheap, but who said fun had to be store-bought? Dr. Katrina Warren is here with the best DIY toys for your dog or cat. Carl is completely engrossed in this beautiful little Dachshund puppy called...
Can I just say this?
What's this one called?
Who cares?
Oh, stop it.
Buddy.
No,
Buddy.
I don't like them because I was savage. As you know, I was savaged by one when I was a kid. And this thing looks like it's going to tear my limb from my
limb. Yeah, it does. It looks menacing. Look at that. Look.
Oh! Again!
And terrifying.
Oh, go, Buddy! Look at your face!
The humanity!
Take him
the
down,
humanity.
Buddy.
Go,
no!
No!
She loves you. She adores you.
Locals in Los Angeles are now embracing the wholesome family pastime of axe throwing the evil spirit to get you away from your mobile phone. Yeah. Why not?
All in this. Hey? Well, it could be worse. It could be a knife.
Who did that?
I don't know. They're both pretty bad.